You know, we've been teaching the works of Christ and greater works and how to do that. We're going to get on in. You know, the Lord spoke to me while I was up yonder somewhere before I came here. He spoke to me and said, the only way the works that I do, that my sons and daughters, and mostly, you know, who's called to do it. Thank you, Jesus. He said they're going to have to deny themselves and take up the cross. Follow him. But I appreciate the Lord. I appreciate people praying for us and Sister Terrell praying for me. Lord, help me to pray 4 hours today. 3.5 of it without even stopping. And I want to pray more. And I used to, when I first started out, I prayed 4 hours. The Lord told me to pray 4 hours or more a day. If I'd do that, I'd preach the gospel to the whole world. You know, this a good life is okay. But thank God for Jesus. I want to, but anyway, while I was out here praying, and thank you, Jesus. Got to get over here to Matthew's 11:22, starting at 11:22 for reading a few verses. Oh, I just feel him. Feel him so real. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. 11:22. And I begin reading at 22. But I say to you, it should be more terrible for Tyre and Sidon at the day of judgment than for you. For O you Capernaum, which are exalted to heaven, shall be brought down to hell. For if the mighty works which have been done in you had been done in Sodom, at Sodom and Gomorrah, it would have remained to this day. Think about it. The miracles and what God is doing today. Probably the old world that we read about, that God destroyed it, wouldn't have been destroyed if we had the gospel that we have from the Lord now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Don't you feel it? But I say to you that it shall be more terrible. Think about that. More terrible, but terrible for the land of Sodom. They are tolerated what God meant for the land of Sodom in the day of judgment than for that you. Jesus answered and said, I thank you, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hid these things from the wise and the prudent and revealed them to babes. That's one of the main things that the Lord opened the scriptures today. I hear prayer. Even so, Father, for it seems good in yours. Think about it. What God is doing today, even right here in just a common holiness church, he said, Sodom and Gomorrah have never been destroyed if they just had a little bit of that. But look where we're going. We are absolutely have lost Christianity in less than 9 years to 10 years. 9 and 10 years ago, 92 to 88% of people in America believed in God Almighty and Jesus Christ in the polls. But today, after 8 years, a little over, of a Muslim man running the White House, we have dropped down to 8%. The polls now say that only 8 to 10% to 12% people in America believes in Jesus Christ. That's why we need a revival. That's the reason if his tent would have been 10 years ago, it'd been back yonder for a prayer tent, right here. We had the world's biggest tent we set up on these lots, right here. That's how far we've got. And that's where we've got to get back to God. That's where we've got to get back to our first love. We've got to get back up on His rock. God said, I'll build my church. If we can get back over us on the rock, which is Jesus and the apostles, He said the gates of hell. You know why the gates of hell is prevailing against us, taking over? We have got off of this rock that Jesus said. If we can get back up on this foundation of the apostles and Jesus Christ Himself, the chief, the apostles, and then the old anxious Old Testament prophets that prophesied, Isaiah, others, that this great revival was coming. You know, prophesied that God was going to pour out His Spirit upon all flesh. Even in Isaiah, that sons and daughters, handmaids, is going to be doing miracles and carrying the gospel. Well, that didn't happen till the late 1800s. But with God, the Bible said 1,000 years is just one day. Yeah. With God. And a year is as 1,000 years with God. One day is 1,000 years. And 1,000 years with God is one day. Otherwise, God don't look at the clock like we do. God don't look at things like we do. And if we will wake up, you remember in the Bible when they run out of wine over in John and had a big supper gathering everywhere. People came in, and you know what Jesus told them? Fill the water pots up. The drums up. The water pots with water. You remember that? To have that first communion. Hallelujah. I said, hallelujah. You said, well, that was then. No, that wasn't then. That is today, yesterday, and forever. I don't put no flowers on me. In Waco, Texas, a little over 50 years ago, I was living there at the time by myself, and they wanted us to have a big meeting, and they wanted over 50,000 people. They showed up, and they wanted me to have the first communion service, first one I ever had. Never done, just a young guy, and over 50,000 people. And the women back in those days cooked we didn't use crackers. They cooked some kind of a bread. Y'all probably know what it is. It ain't got no salt in it and all that. It's just pure bread. And they used that for the bread to do communion. And they used wine, but it wasn't like our wine, probably. And that was, well, we had over 50,000 people, and they wanted me to take control over the preaching part and the other. So we got right in. They wanted me to do the praying before we started having communion. But you know what? The women cooked the bread, but the men didn't bring no wine or grape juice. And what they was using. probably grape juice. And here, 50,000. All of a sudden, we had four brand new drums because where we were, over 50,000, they're going to make us take all the trash and put it in them drums. You know, that was what we had to agree to get that place to have that communion, but they were new drums. All of a sudden, something come over me. I said, fill those drums up with water. God, kill me right now if I ain't telling you the truth. I felt such, at that time I weighed 190 to 200 pounds. And they reached them out, filled them up. I said, God, 2,000 years ago, you was at a pagan wedding, Jesus, and you turned the water to wine for a bunch of pagans. Pagans is people don't believe in God. They got a different God. I said, we're here to have a communion, and this is the first one that I've, since I'd got into the healing ministry, that filled them water pots up. We all lifted our hands. God, kill me right now. God, turn 200 gallons of water into wine. Hallelujah. I mean, wine, just like it did in the Bible. Glory. Something come over me there. Let me know. The hive had been told. The hive had been told what Jesus can do. And that went all over. That went all over the United States and the world. The newspapers cared not how God, when he's still that God. I said he's still God. Hallelujah. He turned the water to wine with the pagans. And what it was, whether it was grape juice wine, done the same thing. Amen. Hallelujah. And that let me know that God said all things are possible if thou canst believe. I want you to know, God hadn't changed. You'll find over in Malachi, he said, I am the Lord, and I change it not. Therefore, your sons of Jacob, or maybe he was like Jacob in those days, was the believers. You know, Christians for that time, they were under Christ. They wouldn't call them Christians, but they called them, you know, they kept the law. Amen. He's still like God.
Amen.
And you got to believe. When Paul wrote here in the Hebrews that Jesus Christ, 13, same today, yesterday, and forever. And what he said? Jesus Christ, the same today, yesterday, and forever. Oh, hallelujah. God hadn't changed. Looks like we lost a lot over that. God hadn't changed. You know what I'm telling you? God is the same now and greater. Because the closer to the end we get, is the more powerful God's going to be. Hallelujah. God now is gleaming the churches. God is, he is rooting up the dead. God is rooting up the false. You know what I'm telling you? God is bringing back in the real, genuine, I call it the real McCoy. He's bringing back the real truth. Jesus can't come for the church world now. Too many beliefs. Four or five different Baptists, over 200 different kind of Pentecostals. Jesus is coming back for one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God. Hallelujah. That's the church he's coming back. One faith, one Lord, one baptism, and Jesus here in his day. Hallelujah. I said in his day. Praise God. He laid the foundation of the church. We know you can't lay the foundation of the church in these modern times. The foundation has already been laid. I said Jesus has done prepared the way for me and you, but we gotta, what I call, sold out. And I mean forsake all if it has to. Take up the cross. Deny yourself. Especially if you got that Bible on your arm and you're going around, you're preaching out of it to people. Today, this ain't just a fun show. This ain't a circus. This is the God bringing the church back up on this rock. He said, I will. And the real church hadn't been built then. The law and the prophets was under Christ. Then Jesus took over and he brought in the Holy Ghost. He brought in salvation. He brought in what we call it Christianity, because Christ, that word Christ means Christian, because Jesus brought back in Christianity, or Christ's spirit, Christ's love, Christ's baptism, Christ the way. Jesus said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. If anybody tries to climb up any other way, he's the same as a thief and a robbery. Hallelujah. That God don't have no 10,000 different beliefs. God said, I'm the way, one Lord. That's what he said. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. But there's over 17 big Pentecostal movements right now in America, and every one of them teaching a different gospel. Five or six different kind of Baptists. All of them teaching a different gospel. Why can't we get back up on this rock? Jesus said, I build my church. No wonder the devil is fighting everybody. No wonder the devil is bringing sicknesses and diseases back on people, because he can't do that. It was up on his rock. We get back up on his rock, Satan can't prevail against us. He said so. He said, if we'll get back up on this rock, which is Jesus Christ, not the apostles of today, but the apostles that Jesus called. Peter with a fisherman out there on catching fish, and he saw him coming. Jesus come walking on the water, and he come and told, come and follow me. Hallelujah. Thank God, when Peter got off and started sinking, then Jesus picked him up. Thank God, Jesus. And then Paul, he was the big shot. But when he saw the miracles, glory, I said, here he come in there with two-thirds of the New Testament, because he had an education. He had some sense. Like, I don't have none. I don't have no sense. All I know is the scriptures. But Paul was an educated man. Hallelujah. We needed that. We needed the book of Acts. We needed Romans. We needed the Corinthians. We'd have never known about the Holy Ghost and the gifts having for Saul getting converted. We needed the Corinthians. Hallelujah. We needed the Hebrews. I said we needed, he wrote the Hebrew. He wrote two-thirds of the New Testament. Why, if he hadn't come in there, even though he was a devil, he killed Christians, but he got saved. God knocked him off his high horse. Hallelujah. And he become the great leader. I said he become the great leader. Glory. I said the leader. And he give us a foundation to build upon. Hallelujah. I said, you give us a foundation. We can build upon it. And it's, you said, will it stand? No, it's already stood. It's already withstood the foundation of Satan. It's already withstood false doctrines. It's already have withstood all lying spirits. It's already healed every sickness. Send his word and heal them and deliver them. His word has already healed every sickness and every disease. You don't say, God, can you do this? He already done it. As an example, he already laid out the way. He already, there ain't no way out, China. He said, I'm the way. I'm the truth. I'm the life. And ain't nobody going to get to my God but through me. I'm the door. I'm the way you got to get in. If you don't come through me, you ain't in. Oh, the cross. And it seemed like nobody wants to. How far did I get? My Lord, I've lost my place. Man, let me start all over. Thank you, Jesus. I say unto you, it should be more terrible for Sodom in the day of judgment than for you. Oh, you companions, what that word is, which are exalted to heaven, shall be brought down to the lower hells. For if the mighty works would have been done in you, that's talking about Sodom and Gomorrah, that was in Sodom, it should remain to this day. And I've been over there three times in my life, that part of the world, and that whole city is still burnt, and they never built it back. There was over 200,000 people went down with it, and that's still there. It's still there. Oh, Sodom's still there. They never did build back that city. And God said it's going to be more terrible. They said over 200,000 people went down in that judgment, according to history, of Sodom and Gomorrah. You know what Sodom and Gomorrah is? It's what the president passed, that a man can marry a man and a woman marry. That's what Sodom is. The president himself passed the law that a man can marry a man and a woman can marry a woman. You know what I'm telling you? And got the low down Congress to got one of the over on that side that one. They like one vote, and one man went over on that side and made that so. So, but it ain't legal. I said it ain't legal. I said it ain't legal. I said it ain't legal. Homosexuality is still going to take people to hell. If you're a homosexual, if you don't get delivered, if you're a lesbian, you're not going to heaven. You're going to have to come through the blood of Jesus Christ. There is no shortcut. I don't care if you don't like it. I don't care what the president and his little bunch of senators got together and got brought over to sell us out. Let me tell you something. Homosexuality is still the devil. God didn't make Adam, didn't make Steve. He made Adam and made Eve. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I said hallelujah. I feel the Baha'u. 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 Shavu. Hazo. Asahasi. I feel God. I feel God. I feel God. He's putting down devils. Putting down all this mess. You know when that law went in not too long back? Before the days were out, over 400 men had married men. Well, come out on, I heard that on the news too, myself. Ain't that sad? We need a revival, people. And you know what the Bible said in the days of the coming of Jesus?
Yes.
So shall it be. And the way, as it was in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. The other way, when they passed the law that the same sex marriage can get married, he said, we're already right in the end time. And that's been, 2 years, 3 years? We're right in here. We need a revival, people. We need to get back upon this rock. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Help me, help me, help me. Oh, you Capernaums, which are exalted to heaven, shall be brought down to hell. For of the mighty works which have been done, and you have been done in Sodom, would remain to this day. But I say unto you that it should be more terrible or tolerated for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for you. Jesus answered and said, I thank you, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you've hid these things from the wise and the prudent and have revealed them to babes. Even so, Father, so it seems good in your sight. All things are delivered to me of my Father, and no man knows the Son but the Father, neither no man any man knows the Father save the Son, and whosoever The Son reveals him. Come unto me, all you that labor. Thank you, Jesus. Take my yoke upon you. Learn of me. God, help me to learn more about you. Learn of me, for I'm meek, lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy, and my burdens are light. Hallelujah. I was out here praying, kneeling, and walking around and praying, and then I was just terribly as. Thank you, Jesus. This evening, glory. Thank you, Lord. And God spoke to me. Thank you, Jesus. I want to go to 1 Peter, just one verse. Oh, I just feel God. I just feel like God helped me. God help me. God help me, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I want to read a couple of verses. I just got down one. It's the 5th chapter of Peter, in verse 5. And chapter 5 and verse 7, but I'm going to read 6. Humble yourselves, therefore, on the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Can't you feel that in Peter's word?
Yes.
You know, Peter, he denied him on crucifixion day because I guess he was afraid. Be sober, vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walks about seeking whom he may devour. Whom you resist steadfast in the faith, knowing the same afflictions are compassing your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who has called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that you suffer a while, makes you perfect, firm, strengthened, settling in you. Think about that. I read a couple of extra verses. But God makes us strong. Makes us strong. Thank you, Lord. Father, we do thank you. God, I thank you with all my heart. Master, God, I thank you, Lord. Jesus, I know I get excited and overexcited, but I can't help it, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for this evening. I really do, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God, I just feel him so real. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. This turn out, we're going to pray for some of you if you're sick. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I feel the Lord. And then we'll have all to call. We'll come and pray at the end. I believe the Lord, and I don't believe there's nothing too hard for God. Brother Taylor, how about you come here and holding these, I'm going to need Sister to help me. Thank you, Jesus. If you need a healing, come over here, and then we may lay hands on Rebbe. But first, I want to pray for folks that are sick. Thank the Lord. We get that little table, too, if we. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, that right there will be okay. If you're sick, we want to pray for you. Got anything in your body? Thank God, Jesus. I felt it this evening. I felt such a glory. Thank the Lord. And I know that Jesus, everybody's got a sickness in your body. Won't you come over here and get in line, and then we'll later lay hands up on those that I feel like God wants to stir some folks up inside. God wants us well. Thank you, Jesus.
I got to go and get a 6 weeks checkup. And I have a condition in my body. And I was praying today and told the Lord, I want to.
You sent over. Okay. Thank the Lord. When are you going back?
Well, whenever I make an appointment.
This week?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Father, right now.
Yes, sir.
Lord, you see the condition that's been in her body.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, she's going back for a checkup. We pray.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, if she goes back.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus, as we get into the new week. God, none of these things.
Whoa, hallelujah.
Be in her body. She came right back out here, Lord, to this meeting and give a testimony.
Yes, Lord.
That by your stripes. Thank God.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's in my stomach. I have a vaginal problem that comes back. They give me antibiotics, and after the antibiotics is over, it comes right back.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, Lord, we ask you to, you see this is in her belly, in her stomach, Lord. She has this problem, and it's better if it comes right back. And what is in here? God, you said, by your stripes. By the power of God. Power of the Holy Ghost. Be healed. Healed. Oh, I felt it. That's healing, ma'am.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I have an old back injury.
What now?
I have old back injury. My back hurts all the time.
Thank you, Lord. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. God, I pray you go down in her back, in the lower back, and up her spine. The power. The power. Oh, I feel it. That's healing. Did it bother you to bend?
Sometimes.
Bend. Touch your toes. Five times. Let me count. One. Two. Three. Four. Five.
Thank you, Jesus.
I haven't been able to touch my toes like that.
Praise God. Lift your hands up, yonder. Hallelujah.
My finger is sore. I can't hardly bend my finger.
Okay. Thank you, Lord. Father, right now, Lord, you see these fingers. God, in Jesus' name. God, go through these knuckles and push your bend of fingers that they won't bother no more. Lord, what's happening in any bones? Lord, one place you said you made fat or made well, the bones. But the power. Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're about to get drunk. Hallelujah.
I got a little pancreatitis in my stomach.
Okay.
Chest. Yes, Lord.
Father, right now, Lord, Lord, you see what's in his chest. And
thank you, Lord.
Stomach.
Yes, Lord.
God, here's one of your children, and it's nothing but the devil.
Hallelujah.
Lord, you call all these things oppressions.
Glory be to God.
Of the devil. That's what you
thank
went about
God.
Healing.
Thank you,
by the
Jesus.
Power of
glory
God.
Glory be to God.
Go hallelujah. Deep down in his chest.
Thank you, Lord.
By the healing power.
Glory be to God.
Oh, I hallelujah. Feel his healing.
In
Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. And Lord, just refire his ministry. God's going
to
refire your ministry.
Thank you, Lord.
By the power of God.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Reset him on fire, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Amen. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. I got, the doctor said I have diabetes, but I don't believe it. But for 7 years, and my brother needs healing in his stomach. He's having pain.
Father, right now.
Oh, gee.
God, right now, Lord, he's taking your word and your stripes for his healing, Lord. God, he's putting his faith in you. Lord, we know medical science is good and medical doctors, but Lord, you are his doctor.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
You're the Lord. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost when I said that.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
You are the Lord that healeth him. His old stomach, all that's in here, it made a whole.
Hallelujah.
By the power of God.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise him, everybody.
I've been having muscle spasms in my neck. And I got a column in my back and a little part of my back.
Father, right now, Lord, you see this in his neck and top of his chest and his back.
Oh,
I felt God there. In his back. Let the power heal him, Lord. God is your servant, and the enemy is attacked in your servants. Through the great power of God, Lord, I pronounce him healed. Oh, I felt it too. Oh, hallelujah. And Lord, as David said, revive him again with fire. Shut up in his bones.
Yes,
I have authorized with tearing perfectly from my eye.
Thank you, Lord. Oh, I felt it already. Touch your Lord back there. I felt it. God done hit her with the healing. God's the arthritis in her hands and her back. God, we're taking authority over it. God, she served you for years and years. God persecuted, but Lord, she's being healed now. God, she's being made whole. Oh, I feel it going all over you. Be made whole. That's healing power. That's healing power. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Jesus. I don't feel it in the man. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Praise him.
I feel so up in my chest, on down my lower back, over my hips.
Father, right now, God, right now, I felt it already. Feel it?
Yes, I do.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Be made whole. Oh, I feel it. Alabarata. Glory. Glory. Come out of there. Pain. Come out of there. Spirit of infirmity. Glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Blood pressure and diabetes. Swelling blood pressure and my diabetes.
Thank you, Lord. God, right now, Lord, we ask you, Master, his blood pressure down in his body, in his back, his whole being. God, you know how to bring us, make us normal.
Yes, Jesus.
God, I appreciate you.
Yeah, Lord.
God, I thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Holy Father.
Thank you, Lord.
God, through the power of
thank
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Oh, thank God.
You. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus.
Be healed.
Yes, Lord.
God, just revive him again.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, Lord, we all, Lord, we get older, but we need to. We look to be revived.
We need you, Jesus.
God, you give him a reviving spirit.
We need you, Jesus.
And all his bones.
Yes, Lord.
And his disc in his bones.
Yes,
with bone
Lord.
Connected to bone.
Yes.
God is healed.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord. I was green. I'm in my two. I was green last night. I don't know what's going on. It's green. I put my driver. It's green.
It's green?
Yes, ma'am. We put my bricks. I'm using bricks in my RPG.
Father, right now, Lord, we already feel the healing power. Lord, we feel the power of the Lord present to heal.
I feel it.
It's going out of your hands, sweetheart. You feel it? That's divine healing. Yes. Made whole.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's done. Glory. Father, right now, Lord, thank you. Lay your hand across her. Father, right now, God, I pray you go down into this heart. You heard the diagnosis. God, we decree.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Lord, you said healing is the children's bread. She's one of your children. And I command all the spirit of infirmity come out of here. There it is. Made whole. Oh, hallelujah. Father, we bless him, Lord. God, let him grow up to be blessed if you tarry. Let him grow up in the fear and the admiration of the Lord. Be raised, Lord, under the power of God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
I had swelling in my right ankle, and then I had problem. My heart been hurting.
Thank you, Lord. God, right now, Lord, we ask you, Lord, to go down through her whole body and down in her chest and her lungs. Make her heart and all her organs work perfectly. Oh, I feel it. I do. I feel healing. By his stripes, I can hear the Spirit saying, you are healed. By his stripes, the Spirit is saying, you are healed. Made whole. Raise your hands and begin to praise him. Praise him. Bend over a little bit.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Let me get one higher. Please,
hallelujah. Praise God. Praise him. Give him a big praise.
Thank you, Jesus, Lord. I thank you.
Diabetic, and I fell, fractured my right knee. I have problems with mine, and then you have problems with the top of my skin.
Thank you, Jesus. God, we pray in her chest and her eyes and through her whole body. God, you see that she needs a miracle of healing. Make her eyes strong. Down in her chest and stomach, upper stomach. I feel it just happening right now. Be made whole. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Doctor said I gotta lick it down.
Okay. Thank you, Lord. She got a leaky valve in her heart. God, right now. God, I pray that the doctors have diagnosed one of her valves of her heart's leaky. Lord, I ask for a miracle. God, when she gets back, what time he told her to come back, God ain't going to be there. You're fixing it right now. Lord, ain't going to be no blood coming out of there. Oh, hallelujah. Ain't going to be no blood coming out of there. No heart leakage of the heart. Hallelujah. You're made whole.
Thank you, Jesus. Ooh, hallelujah.
Okay. Father, right now, Lord, we ask you to heal this old diabetes, Lord. It's nothing but the devil. Oh, she's too young for this, and if she's old, she'd be too young. God's nothing but the devil. God, I pray you go through her organs, Lord, her liver and her heart and all that produces her natural sugar, Lord. God, that she ain't gonna have no diabetes. You foul spirit of diabetes, I cast you off of her. Command her organs to produce all the fluid that she needs. In Jesus' name, praise God. Glory. Talk a little bit now. Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you, Lord. God, the doctor diagnosed her with high blood pressure, but we believe right now, through your great, I feel the Lord. I feel the Lord just going down through you. God, make her blood pressure normal. I don't know when she goes back, probably sometime next week, but she's going to get a good report. Or her blood pressure going down, even 10 or 12 below what it's supposed to be. By the power of God, Jesus Christ heals you.
I'm diabetic, and I've had breast cancer.
Okay.
It's been years ago, but it's trying to come.
Just lay your hand across her. Father, right now, Lord, God, I pray that you'll heal this diabetes and this down in this chest, Lord, this diagnosed cancer, but we believe it, that it's cursed. God, we curse cancer in her blood. We curse cancer in her body. God, we decree it. You curse their infirmities. And I curse this thing through your blood, through your name, through your stripes, Jesus. I command her, decree her, speak healing. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Glory.
Hello. I'm having a problem with my disc, three discs on my left side.
You're okay, back there. Father, right now, God, I pray for these three discs that's in her back that needs to be fixed. I feel it going down back of your neck. Oh! Oh!
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, be made well. God, I command you to fix all them discs between them spinal, that back. It's done. That's power. Healing power. Healing power. By my stripes, he's saying, you're healed. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Female problem. I go back to
the doctor
at 30.
Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Female problem. Thank you, Jesus. Touch it. God, right now, Lord, I pray you go into her lower organs. We denying it, Lord. God, we kept decreeing that a miracle. God, let the doctor say, well, he just misdone it, but Lord, it's done because you done it. You healed her. You went down inside of her.
Oh, receive it.
And healed her.
Oh, hallelujah.
It won't be found.
Oh, God. Ooh, so thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Mighty Jesus.
Please deliver from all medication.
Father, right now, Lord, God, he wants to get off of all medication. Lord, he wants to get on Jesus-cation. Father, in Jesus' name, be hooked on your stripes. That by your stripes, by your healing, you are the Lord that heals us, you said. I am the Lord that healeth thee. Be made well and whole.
Hallelujah.
And offer all medicine.
Thank you.
Praise God. Father, right now, Lord, we pray for this brother. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. Lord, just keep him growing in the faith. And God, as he comes into the knowledge, more knowledge of Jesus. Oh, Lord. Just open up his understanding by the power of Jesus Christ. God, in the name of Jesus. Just give him a whole revelation of you, Jesus. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord.
My vision is very blurry, and I went to the doctor for my left foot and on my,
okay.
On the top of my head.
Okay. Okay, give me a chair down there. Thank you, Jesus. Put that over her head there.
Okay, from the
top. I'm going to touch your foot here in just a moment. Lord, right now, her eyes and, oh, Lord, and her whole body. Make her eyes and her whole body. I feel it. While she's feeling that spirit going in, I'm going to touch this left foot, and God's going to heal it. God, right, oh, I feel it. God, let that healing power go down from her head and her body and her head, on down into this ankle. Oh, Lord, put healing in here. Satan, I cuss you with the blood of Jesus, with the cross of Calvary. Thank God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Won't you start dancing?
Thank you, Jesus.
Start dancing. You can do it. Come on. Come on, dance. You can do it. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Hallelujah.
When I was walking up here, I was just blur my eyes. I mean, everybody looked like we're going just side to side. But Lord Jesus, I thank you right now. Everybody is still. You all are still.
Hallelujah! When she come up here, her eyes were blurred. She just couldn't blur it. Now she sees everything clearly because there's somebody up yonder is coming down here through the Holy Ghost.
I'm the good talk player of Brother Michael Brady Church. You know what I mean? I'm the good talk player of Michael Brady Church. You know what I mean? Ma'am. Ma'am, just tell me that I'm from Michael Brady Church. I'm the good talk player of Michael Brady Church. I got prayer.
Okay.
Brother Charles, I have a lot of mucus build up in my lungs. And sometimes it hurts when I breathe.
Father, right now, Lord, you heard her request and all this is in her lungs about her breathing. They're going to let her breathing be perfect.
Yes,
Jesus. Lord, hear what's trying to clog up or open them up. Oh, I feel it. And Lord, all this other request, it's done too. God done it all. Be unto you what you have asked for. Say the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise him.
My right knee and my feet.
That's here. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come over this way just a little bit. God, right now, Lord, you see the soul, right knee and her chest too. God, by the power of God, Lord, fix his knee. God, fix his old cartridges, and sometimes and they get wore out, but you put them back in. God, I know you're real. And heal her whole body. God, right now, Lord, it's like bone on bone, but you fix it. Fix the Lord and through your own power of healing. By your power, by your stripes. I felt it right there. Start dancing. Oh. Hallelujah. Lord. Glory. Praise God. Somebody say Jesus is in the tent. Somebody left some shoes.
Oh,
I don't know who's that. What's going on?
Jesus. Chest pain.
pain, she said.
Thank you, Lord. God, right now. God, right now, Lord, these chest pains. Oh, it's happening right now. The healing's already going through you. It's like it's about, the power's so strong on you, it's like you're about to get drunk. By the power of the Holy Gabo, battle, be healed.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, my eyes.
Yeah.
I had a red eye. Thank you.
You have my red eye. Okay.
Your eye. Which one? This eye?
Okay.
Pink eye.
Pink eye.
Father, right now, fix this eye. Lord, make it perfect. Lord, he's too young. If he's 100, he'd still be too young. Lord, all this is the devil. God, in the name of Jesus, make his eye 20/20 perfectly.
It's pink eye. It's an infection.
Infection. God, take the infection out of it.
Yeah.
That's happening right now. God, move all. Oh, God. We better be all right.
Pray for my mom. She had high blood pressure today.
Okay.
And
thank you, Lord.
And continue to heal me from sin.
Uh-huh.
And ask the Lord to continue to heal me from sin.
Okay. Father. Father, right now, Lord, we send this handkerchief to his mama. The Lord, he need you to move in him. God, right now, Lord, we thank you for the blood of Jesus that cleanses us from all sin and forgives us. Thank you, Lord, for loving us that much to come to the world. Right now, through the power of the blood, make him strong. Lord, if he's committed any sin, you said his sins be forgiven him. Let him grow deep.
Yes.
Deep in Christ. By the power, God, I impart a deeper walk, a greater experience in the Lord. Oh, in Jesus' name. Praise God.
My right ankle gets swollen.
Okay, hand me that chair. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God. God, right now, God, I pray of what's causing this right ankle to be swollen. And Jesus, fix it. Or let her wake up in the morning at what time she gets up and no swelling. God, I thank you for your presence. Lord, the Bible said the power of the Lord is present. And it's your power that's doing this. Be made well. That'll be able to dance and shout. God, through your glory, be healed. I impart healing in Jesus' name. I believe you stump it. Come on, dance a little bit. That is. Woo! Hallelujah. Praise God.
Blood clots.
Huh?
Two blood clots in my
Two blood clots.
My fingers are numb. The doctor put it in there.
Father, right now, Lord, for these blood bumps, Lord, we pray your bloody blood clots dissolve them, and or these knuckles and a bending of her wrist and her fingers.
Yes, Lord.
God, let everything. I feel it.
In the soul of my name.
I feel it, God. There it is.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Leave tomorrow after the service tomorrow, but Pastor Dennis, his liver has been going. Pastor Dennis, so I got to stand in proxy.
For him. Okay.
Yeah, out in Baltimore.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Fordham.
How you need?
About 8.
Okay. Thank you, Jesus.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Tomorrow.
Thank you, that's okay. He meets people on the highways. He's a trucker. But he's going, thank the Lord. I feel the Lord. There we are.
Jesus.
Praise God. Lord, I send this word with these kerchiefs, Lord, and anointed for God. He'd be meeting truckers and people. God, and I pray the mighty power of God be with him and protect him. Oh, God. Oh, I feel it. My God, I feel fire.
Hallelujah.
Fire.
Yes, do it, Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Just like from here down, I need rebuilt.
God, right now, Lord, he needs from his waist on down just a total. Oh, I feel it. Lord, heal all of this in his waist and his stomach and his lower back, down into his legs and his muscles. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hand me that cruise moment. I'm going to, like the Lord just told me, I'm going to anoint you. You got a work to do, I'm going to anoint you. You be back in here before the meeting. I'll anoint you from the horn, but I'm going to anoint you. Thank God, giving you a fresh anointing tonight. You've been praying for God to move like he moved a few years ago. It's coming all back.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. 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 God's rejuvenating you. Oh, hallelujah. God's letting the fire that's been shut up in your bones be lit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise him, everybody. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. God just giving him a fresh ordinary. He's ordaining him afresh. He's getting a fresh ordained. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I just want you to pray for me, Pastor.
Okay. God, he's offering himself up to you as a body, Lord, his whole tabernacle. He wants you to bless him and let him come into what he's down in his heart is reaching out for. God, give him that blessing of fire shut up in his bones and keep him in health, protecting him. Protect him from sin out there. Protect him from the powers and principalities of the air through the power of God. Oh, I feel the Lord. You got a work to do, but it ain't too late. God's refiring you. God, you was back like 16, maybe. Somewhere's in there. You, Lord done a work for you. And God still got that call in you. God still got that call in you. This is the day he's given us a freshness. Power.
Protection. Protection.
Okay. Lord Jesus, we ask you to bless him, Lord. He wants you to keep your hand on, protect him, and keep him. God, keep him from the principalities and all the powers and the rulers and the darkness of this world. He's just growing up a little young man. But keep him, God. Let the blessings of the Lord be with him. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
Back pains. Back pains.
Lord, right now, Lord, heal these back pains. And Lord, he's too young for that, and it has to be the devil. Let the power of God, Lord, move all of this out of here. It'll never happen again. I'm talking about right this moment. By the power. Heal. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to bend over and touch your toes 3 times. Do it. Again. Let's do it 5. That's 3, 4, 5. Now lean backwards. Feel okay?
Yes.
Praise God. Come on, praise the Lord. Come on, give God praise.
want you to pray for me the Lord anoint me to do a work for him.
Huh?
I want you to pray for me the Lord do it anoint me to do a work for him.
See what she...
She needs to be anointed to do a work.
Okay. Thank the Lord. God, right now, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Do it.
Yeah.
Hit the highways and hedges. Oh, hallelujah. Praise God.
After 31 years, I walked away from management in Walmart, so I want to be re. So I just quit.
What a rededication. She's been working 31 years in Walmart, and now she's retired. She wants to be rededicated to the Lord.
Father, right now. Oh, hallelujah. Lord, pour out upon her. Lord, you said in the last days that you pour out your spirit on all flesh, man and woman, handmaids and servants, Lord. God, we ask it for a mighty power of a miracle. She can get out here and do what she wants to do, Lord. She's done fulfill her time, Lord, on a job that Father Jesus to retire. Now she wants to refire for you. Oh, I felt that. There you are. She retired from Walmart, refiring with Jesus. Hallelujah. Going back to work for Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise him. Hallelujah. Reach over and take somebody's hand and say, Jesus still in the tent.
I hurt.
Only down on my
leg. How's that been going?
I hurt. I'm doing better, but I still hurt.
Hurt right now?
Yeah.
Well, you ain't going to be in a moment.
Well, praise the Lord.
Lord, right now, Lord, she stays in pain.
Oh,
hurts, but she ain't no more.
Oh,
come out of her pain.
Oh,
come out of her pain. Go from her.
Jesus.
Go from her.
Oh,
go from her.
Oh,
there it is.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now stand up. You ain't no pain now.
Yeah. Well, I'm not in pain, but it's tight. It feels tight.
Well, Ben, touch
I
your toe.
Tight.
Come on, you got it. Touch your toe. Uno. Do it again. Dos.
Oh, praise the Lord.
Cinco.
Ah, thank you, Jesus.
Six.
Hallelujah.
Ucho, new every dash.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Heal.
Jesus.
I feel good.
I feel good. Thank you.
Praise him, everybody.
Hallelujah.
I want you to pray for the Lord to put them where he wants them at.
Pray what now?
The Lord to put my kids where he wants them at.
Where he wants them?
Yes, whether
you or
going through a divorce right now.
Okay.
Father, right now, Lord, God, we ask your blessing upon this little girl, Lord, in life, and this brother, Jesus, that he'll be able to get on that channel. God, do what he feels that you want him to do, and he feels he's called to do.
Yes.
Oh, almighty God. God, we give you thanks. We give you Holy Ghost thanks.
Oh, I
feel it. Power.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, the Lord is saying he just somehow he set you free. Thank God you've been set free. You've come out of one position, but God has brought you out of something into something deep, called to the deep. Satan tried to hinder you, but God has blocked him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory.
Pain and sore. Right.
Thank you, Jesus. God, move this sore pain out of her left side here, Lord. You're more than able to know what's causing it. God, in the name of Jesus, make her well. Make her well, Lord. And Lord, she's weak. Make her strong. For the power. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is restoring. The devil's been fighting your appetite, but God, thank you, Jesus, get kindling. Then you gain some strength. You've been in a weak condition because your appetite, you just didn't want nothing, but God's going to let you eat like you need to eat, and you're going to be strong. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory, glory. Let's stand on our feet and give God a good praise. I didn't know there'd be that many, but that's okay. Praise God. Let's come around the altar. Thank the Lord. That's a good healing. Let's come around the altar here and praise God and pray for America. You know, pray for America. America needs prayer. Thank the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Let's lift our hands up and praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Be here in the morning. Now we're going to be here. I think they're starting at 10. So get on in here. And let's everybody pray for this country. Yes. America's in a mess, and we can head it off. Yes. We can head it off. So let's come and pray. Yes. Praise the Lord. And ever who will lead prayer. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come on around the altar, everybody. Lord, we thank you. Come on. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Everybody pray. Father, we thank you, Lord. God, for what you've done here, Jesus, tonight, Lord, for us. You've seen all of our needs, Lord. Lord, the yokes, chains, and feathers, Lord, that have had us hindered. You've seen, Lord, God, the need that we had in our bodies. And Lord, you touched us, God, through the man of God. And Lord, we thank you for it. Lord, we pray and ask it right now. Lord, as you, Lord, restoring us and mending our lives, God, and causing us, Lord God, to reach out once again. Lord, we pray, Lord, not only for ourselves, but God, this nation. Lord, this country, Lord, the leaders, Lord, they don't know what to do. Oh, Jesus. And we pray, Lord, for America. We pray, Lord, for our brothers and sisters in the foreign fields. But, Lord, we need you now, Lord. Lord, our eyes, Lord God, is beholding the fulfillment of your word. All the things that you spoke, Lord, that you say will happen in these days and in these times. We're literally seeing it, Lord, right before our eyes. Lord, the news is full, Lord, of disasters, floods, God, and tornadoes. God, tsunamis, Lord. We're seeing the streets, Lord God, God, like rivers. Waters running down the street. Lord, we don't know what it's going to take. I know your people is seeing all these things. Lord, what manner of person should we be? Oh, Lord, as we look and see, God, that you've spoken right here at hand, and your coming is soon at hand, Lord. Oh, God, with all holy conversation, as we look waiting, Lord God, Lord, for your return, Jesus, help us Lord to get in that place with you. We know that you sit in this word this week, Lord, to restore us, to bring us back, Lord, to the place, God, when we first believe you, that joy, that peace, God, that we had in our soul. Oh Lord, we feel that restoration. We feel that healing virtue, that power, Lord, that you're sending down, God, from above. Oh, we feel it, Lord, in our hearts. Lord, I pray. We pray tonight. Lord, as we put our voices together, we pray, Lord God, for this nation. We pray, God, for the leaders, Lord, of this nation, God. Oh, Jesus, we pray for the ministers and the handmaids, everybody pray. And the handmaids and all of your servants. Oh, Lord, put a burden upon our shoulders. Lord, for souls. Lord, put a hunger and a thirst down in our hearts. God, for righteousness, that we can be clothed once again, Lord God, with righteousness. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Thank you for seeing our needs tonight. Thank you for seeing the needs, God, of this country. Lord, we know it's going to take a turning. It's going to take a turning, Lord, back to you, Lord. And Lord, let it start this week. Lord, hear in our hearts. Put a burden in our hearts for souls. Oh God, put a burden. Come on, lift your hand and tell him. Put a burden, Lord, in our hearts for souls, Lord. Oh Lord, help us first of all to be concerned about our own soul, Lord. And then we can be concerned about others. Oh Jesus, do something in Memphis, Lord, this week, Lord. Lord, do something in our lives. Do something in our brothers and our sisters' lives, Lord. Oh God, we can't make it without you, Lord. Jesus, our hope is in you. Our hope is in you. Come on, tell her. Our hope is in you. Oh Jesus, we ask you, Lord. We ask you. You said, Lord, if we ask, you said you give. Lord, you said if we seek, we'll find. We ask you tonight. Oh God, we seek tonight. We come, Lord, knocking tonight. Oh Lord, we pray and ask it right now. Help us to open our hearts. You know how, Lord, to open our hearts. Open our hearts tonight, God. Lord, forgive us of our sins. Forgive us, Lord, for that slothfulness, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, for that unconcernedness about souls, God. Forgive us, Lord, and put a return in our spirit, that we can return back to you. Come on, lift your hand and praise him tonight. Thank him for your healing tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Glory, you that felt the power of God go down in your soul and touch your body and heal that condition that you had. You need to lift your hand tonight. What the doctors can do, God done it for you tonight. You need to lift your hand and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, praise him. Oh, glory. We praise you for our healing. We praise you for, Lord, our deliverance. We praise you, Lord, for touching our bodies. We praise you, Lord, for healing our minds, our souls, and our spirit. We praise you tonight, Jesus. Oh, we reverence you. And we thank you. Lord, we pray the man of God's strength. God, we pray. God, the woman of God's strength tonight. And Lord, we're thankful in our hearts. Lord, for you being mindful of us. And send this word back to Memphis one more time. Oh, Lord, we ask you, Lord. God, don't let the coming be in vain. Oh, Jesus. Lord, I ask to you tonight. Open up my heart. I can't speak for nobody else. That I can receive what you have for us. I see where you're trying to get us, Lord. You're trying to get us in a place, God, with you, Lord. That not only we can be a help to ourselves, but Lord, we can be a help to dying and lost souls, God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Have mercy. Have mercy on this nation. Have mercy on this country, Lord. We know that you were speaking tonight. God, we know it's real. Oh, if you didn't spare, Lord, the angels that sin. If you didn't spare Sodom and Gomorrah. Lord, we know you ain't going to spare in this day and this time. Oh, God. But, Lord, if you help us. If you help us. Lord, you said you would. You said you'd help us, Jesus. If you help us tonight, God, oh Lord, as we turn our face to the wall and cry out to you and ask you to remember us one more time. One more time, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, we thank you. Come on, you mean it? Lift your hand and thank him tonight. He didn't have to do what he done. He done what the doctor. doctors can't do. Oh, hallelujah. And we need to thank him tonight. Just take time to thank him tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Just a moment from the depth of your heart. Raise your hand and tell Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I thank you tonight for being mindful of me, looking down on me, healing my body, being concerned about me. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Lord, move. Move in this revival, the rest of this revival. Oh God, your will, Lord God, that we be alive and be here, Lord God, tomorrow. Oh, let us come here, Lord, with thankful heart. Let us come with joy in our souls. Let us come with a peace of mind that you're going to do that, Lord, that we need done in our lives. Oh, Lord, we accept our healing tonight. We accept this word tonight, Lord. We accept, Lord, that you've given to the man of God tonight. Oh, Jesus, we accept it. We receive it tonight. And we thank you for it. Oh, Lord, in Jesus' name. Oh, we bless your name tonight. Thank you, Lord. Come on, lift your hand, somebody. Lift your hand, somebody. Oh, Jesus. Come on, praise him.